I'm JD, welcome to my channel. Please like, as it says, subscribe, and share this video. Today we're going to be assembling a Zenith 133.8 bumper movement. This is Zenith 133.8 bumper movement. This is a very unique movement as the rotor is a 3/4 rotor, and it bumps from side to side to wind the movement. I did do a disassembly video of this so you can see that, and here we're assembling it very carefully. There's not a lot to talk about in the assembly, so just please watch the assembly and enjoy, and I'll stop where there's pertinent points. It's not an easy watch to assemble because it's not a normal automatic watch that you'd be familiar with Seiko and other watches. This is a very unique Zenith watch, very high caliber, and I think these things are very sought after watches. So please enjoy. On another note, I can't monetize the video because the music I put in, the canned music, seems to find copyright problems. So I don't have any background music playing while I'm assembling this watch. But I suggest you turn on your radio and listen to some really cool jazz while you're watching this assembly happen. I also suspect that if you're watching this video, you're probably trying to deal with this bumper movement and actually trying to reassemble it yourself, and you're watching what I'm doing so you can just repeat it and do the assembly of the watch. It is tricky, as you can see as I'm farting around with the bridge for the pallet fork here. So anyway, I could talk over this one here, but I'm not going to. So I gotta get to the cottage. So thanks for watching my videos, and I'll catch you later. Bye-bye. I guess some final notes about this movement. It is the 133.8 Zenith movement. It won awards for accuracy. There has been the 155 movement from Zenith as well. As you can see, it's a 20 jewel Swiss made movement. And you can see the complexity of assembling this movement. It is not an easy watch to take apart and assemble. Some of you might think it's not a problem, but that intermediate plate that you saw on the top, I had to remove that in order to get the balance in. So I didn't realize that you could not put the balance in until you remove that plate and the rotor, and then you've got access to the balance from that. So it's running fairly well right now. I'm going to let it run overnight, or I'm going to let it actually run for the weekend, and just to work it in properly. And then after I've let it run for quite a while, I'll time it to make sure that there's no issue with respect to its beat error and or its timing. So it's winding nicely, as you can see. I'm just moving it back and forth. And it's an interesting design for the wind. It only winds in one direction, but it resets when it comes back from winding. I had just a little bit more oiling to do at the top here that I wanted to get done. Again, thank you very much for watching this. I apologize I didn't talk my way through this movement, but I had to really concentrate to get this thing done, and it would have been a very long voiceover, so I just threw some jazz music in there in the background. And you can watch this or let it play in the background. So thanks a lot for subscribing to my channel. This is the first video out there to show the complete reassembly of the bumper movement. So this will be useful for any watchmakers who have to do work on this vintage movement in the future. So thanks a lot, and I'll see you next time.